And today I'm throwing a large swirly buzz, 1.6 kilos of clay. Haven't done one of these in a little while. See how it goes. Video. I only have a very small kiln really, so I only ever do larger pieces than they're specifically asked for. And when I say large parts, it's not that large in the grand scheme of things, just large in comparison to most of the stuff I make. Some of the vases, some people consider large, in my kiln at all. Voices about the glasses I normally make, that the opening's too big. You have to have loads of flowers to fill it out, otherwise they just sort of collapse. So that's something I always try and allow for nowadays. Adding the swirls will drop the height of it. So it's always good to get it taller first. A bit taller than you actually want the end thing to be. As I was saying, that's too wide. So I can colour that in and get a bit more height there too. You can always check to see how fast you need to move your hand by drawing a speed in the play, and you'll see how far apart the pattern is. In that case, it's about that, so it's a bit possibly on the fast side. Let's see. So you push out until you see the play bend the amount you want. Both hands come up together and watch for when the pattern meets itself, so the lower finger is in the groove that the upper finger created on the previous turn. And you always want to back off the pressure up at the top, keep the rim level. That's alright. Mentioned, should close that in a bit. Also keep that all centered. The narrower you make it, the harder it is to stand it upside down to trim. So I don't want to. Well, it depends. You can do it on a chuck and then it's alright. So I'll trim at the bottom. They help, but I find they're not that absorbent. So you get a sponge down there, but don't really get that much water up. Swirly Vase. I'll be quite gentle with them.